All this to the people who were listening, he entered Capernaum. And as the centurion's servant, whom his master valued highly, was sick and about to die. The centurion heard of Jesus and when some elders of the Jews and sent some elders of the Jews to him asking him, that is Jesus, to come and heal his servant. When they came to Jesus, they pleaded earnestly with him, "This man deserves to have you do this because he loves our nation and has built our synagogue." So Jesus went with them. He was not far from the house when the centurion sent friends to say to him, "Lord, don't trouble yourself, for I do not deserve to have you come under my roof." That is why I did not even consider myself worthy to come to you. Just say the word and my servant will be healed. For I myself am a man under authority with soldiers under me. I tell this one to go and he goes, and that one to come and he comes. I say to my servant, "Do this," and he does it. When Jesus heard this, he was amazed, and turning to the crowd following him, he said, "I tell you, I have not found such a faith, even in Israel." Then the men who had been sent returned to the house and found the servant well. I'm not worthy. No matter how much I've done, no matter how many people I've helped, no matter how many people I've fed, no matter how people I've enabled to move toward healing, I'm not worthy. What a powerful example in the scripture, where a person, centurion was a person who, and the very word centurion means 100, right? Who had hundreds of, maybe even thousands, of soldiers who were under his command. He was empowered to make decisions for the government of Rome in that particular area of his life. And he had, obviously, connection with the nation of Israel, who at that time was not that great of a nation in terms of numbers, but they were under his jurisdiction. And because of that, those who were under that jurisdiction were often found catering, if you will, to his authority. Oh, that happens a lot. That's what lobbyists do. you know, cater to authority. And so, therefore, he had a treasured servant. Now, anybody can have people that are very close to them, but when you have a relationship with a servant, that is one who meets your needs, amen, who meets your needs and will be someone with whom you're confident that if you give them a word, they will carry it. You don't have to think about it another time. Amen. Amen. You know, now my children are another thing. Amen. I can tell them one thing, Audrey, and they don't remember. I was saying this to Cindy this morning. It seems that my son doesn't remember anything until he needs money. He remembers, hey Susan, he remembers how to call when he needs some money. For a broken down car or something. You know what I'm saying. Anybody understand what I'm saying? There are people in our lives who are dependent upon us when they need money. I can't hear amen or nothing.
Amen.
Amen. Mm-hmm. My granddaughter said amen. But this servant was obviously someone that the centurion cared deeply for. Amen. There are people in our lives that we care deeply for, and we ask God to do things for them, even though we know that when we're asking, we are not worthy. I'm grateful to have been allowed to meet my age of 60 plus now, and I'm just grateful that God has allowed me to live. Amen. In spite of my failures, in spite of my circumstance, God continues to bless me. I would imagine, Joe Novak, that it is only because God has something else for me to do. Amen. God has placed us here for purpose. I said, God has placed us here for purpose. And no matter how young or old you are, we all have something to do for the purpose of God. Now, whether we realize it or not, that's the reason why we're here. It's not because we've been good. No, don't think that. Don't leave it thinking, I'm here because I've been good. No, you're here because God has something greater for you to do in your life. Amen. You may think that things are done, I don't have to do anything else with the church. Sometimes it's not even about the church, it's about yourself. Amen. Sometimes we think we can do everything for everybody, but sometimes when we have to do things for ourselves, I must tell you as a living witness, when you have to do things for yourself, sometimes it is the most difficult thing to do in your life. Mm-hmm. Sometimes, if you know that there are things that you need to start eating right, I wish I had my witness as we go into the picnic. When you look at that table and say, "Oh, I don't need to eat this," you're probably right. Amen, amen. So the centurion was very clear, but I'm not sure those who were coming to him were very clear. Listen to what they said. He's been good for our nation. Amen. Mm. Amen. Well, I love the nation. I love the United States of America. But if I'm taking care of the United States of America before I take care of me, there's something wrong. Mm-hmm. Am I right about that? Mm-hmm. When you come into a situation where you're asking God to do something for somebody else that you have not done for yourself, there's something terribly wrong. Am I making any sense to you today? If so, say amen or raise your hand.
Amen.
There are things that the centurion was evident. This is why Jesus said, He's seen nothing greater, no faith greater in Israel. Because here's a guy who has all kind of power, John, all kind of power to have people move. He can move a brigade of people at a word. He didn't have to think twice about it. He can say to his understudies, move. And a brigade of people will move at one time. But that was not enough. That kind of authority was man's authority. Amen. You see, there are all kinds of authority. But the authority of man is often limited. But the authority of God, given to you, is all power. What have they said about faith? If you have a mustard, I'm not saying happy, by the way. If you have a mustard seed of faith, you can move mountains. You know? Now my earthly senses are, I didn't really talk about mountains like Camp Beacon. No. I think they're talking about the mountains of emotional problems in our lives. Everybody has a problem. Name, anybody here has no problems? Raise your hand. No, I mean absolutely. Come on, Roy. Yeah, but you don't listen to everything after 62 years. I know you for myself.
I just have to do with a bullet.
As long as she sees you. Okay. Amen, somebody. I'm not worthy. I'm not worthy, but I am able to call on God. I may not be worthy to do things, but you know what? God is a forgiving God. Jesus has taught us about forgiveness. Forgiveness is something that we are not entitled to, but it is something that if we ask the Savior to help us, comfort, strengthen, and keep us, Jesus is willing to aid us. Jesus will carry us through. Here's my question today. Are there any things in your life that you need?